What to do about unwanted noise in measurements? Here we have mounted a strain gauge to measure the deformation. As you can see, the sensor signal is very noisy. High frequency spikes are on top of the useful signal, which is around 700 micrometer per meter. For demonstration, we built a noise generator, which switches a current of 2 amperes with 1 kHz through the red and black cables, which are then inducing into the sensor cables. Let's use first some free cables. It gets worse when moving the two wires apart, when they span a surface. Remember, the useful sensor signal was around 700 micrometer per meter, and we induce here much more than that. Now let's use twisted cables. Both conductors receive now exactly the same noise, and the Dewesoft differential amplifier cancels it out. Third, we have a twisted shielded cable, but we forgot to connect the shield. Let's connect the shield on the amplifier side. Now even other sources from the environment, like this 20 kHz switching frequency, get muted. So the sensor signal looks useful and nice now. But is it good enough? Let's zoom in. There's still a small noise of around 10 micrometer per meter peak peak on it. Now that we have first optimized our cabling, we can now apply a filter on the analog input signal. Of course, first we should ensure that our useful signal doesn't contain any components higher than 1 kHz. One disadvantage of this method is that your original signal will be modified. But you can also keep the original unfiltered analog channel and instead add some virtual Dewesoft MUD filter channel. This also can be changed later, by the way. Our philosophy is always to store the raw data, because this will give you the opportunity to go back and correct wrong assumptions later.